Post-match chat is live. The second match between South Africa and Pakistan, the I-20 series, three, and South Africa, well, Frank wiped the floor with Pakistan this time around. I did suspect personally that they would get one game in this series. Well, after this, maybe they'll get more than one. They won with 36 balls to spare, completely and totally dismantled Pakistan today. And we're going to talk all about it. I've got, as always, I'm Atif Nawaz, you know me. I've also got my special friends, Anam Nadeem, Arman, and very special today, the founder of the Fem Games, a diehard Pakistani cricket fan, Eba Qureshi. Eba, thank you so much for joining us. I wish we could have brought you on when there was a better day and Pakistan had won a game, but sadly they've lost the game today. Tell me, Eba, you watched the game. What was your favorite performance of today's match?
Hello, everybody. So, Atif, thank you for having me on today. I try and avoid these kinds of podcasts because I get into trouble most of the time, but I think I get into enough trouble on Twitter, so I try and avoid as much giving my opinion on different platforms. But you're a dear friend, so I'd love to, you know, give my opinion today. So your question was the best moment, was it?
Best performance.
So I'm stuck between two. I was thinking about this earlier. I'm stuck between two, and it's either Markram or obviously Linde. I think they both performed really well. I think that it's a little bit unfortunate that, you know, when you're an all-rounder, you kind of take away the player of the match kind of, you know, award. And I just, for some reason, I was still edging towards Markram. I thought he played really well today. He took some very crucial catches from South Africa earlier on. You know, and then obviously he batted extremely well. But I think mine personally, Markram.
Yeah, Aidan Markram, can't complain with that at all. It was fantastic performance from him. 50 in very good time gave South Africa the impetus to chase down the low total that Pakistan set them. Anam Nadeem, aapka favorite performer kaun tha aaj ka? What was your favorite performance?
My South Africa ka kaptan jo hai Hendrik Claassen, mera favorite performer aaj wo tha. Ek to score bhi kiya 36 banaye 21 balls pe. And the way he handled the team, ek to team changes nahi the bilkul bhi. And he showed faith in his bowlers as well. Composed captain tha, stumps ke piche kafi acha tha. So mere liye aaj, I think Claassen was really good.
He was absolutely brilliant in the absence of Tender Bavuma. Stepped up and did a great job for his team. Arman Kirmani, I can't wait for this. I'm sure a lot of our viewers can't. What was your favorite performance of today's match?
Yeah, dekho sab itni South Africa tarif kar rahe hain, so I have to, you know, balance it out a little bit. My favorite performance was Hassan Ali, 6-6 out, strike rate 400. Thank you very much. Take notice of me. Put me up the order. Doesn't matter if Pakistan win or lose. I'm consistent. Hassan Ali for me.
Yeah, he's playing that pinch hitter role remarkably well at the moment. I mean, I know he could go on a bit more. Maybe he could organize himself. He can't point the finger at Hassan Ali. He's hitting the ball, unlike some of the other players. I'll throw in a Pakistani favorite player today as well. I'll go with
Oh my God, is he gone?
Sorry about that. I beg your pardon. Issue there. We're back. So. Usman Dabe is my player of the match. He had a difficult game in the previous game. A lot of people questioning his inclusion, but he came back, was economical compared to the rest of the bowlers, and he got himself two wickets. So, though it didn't impact the match, it was something that I took notice. So, I'm going to say that spell was my favorite performance match. Now this is going to give you guys a lot of space. Pakistan scored 140 odd runs in 20 overs for a loss of 9 wickets. So I'm expecting that people will be upset, people will be angry. Tell me, living in perspective, tell me, what was your least favorite? We don't see worth.
Guys, I don't know if you guys are losing. He's asking for your least favorite. Least favorite. I think, Eba, that question would go to you anyways, as you're our guest. What was your least favorite performance of the day, just in case Atif cut off for you, because he did cut off for me?
I was going to say pass on to this question because I don't like saying least favorite. I think I can't have a least favorite, at least from Pakistan anyway. But if I really have to say, I can't say least favorite. I'd just say that I was expecting a little bit more from this particular player than it would be Shergill. We all have this, you know, we really like having him back on the international scene. He did quite well in the PSL, you know, in the first half that we just saw. But I just felt that the catch that he dropped as well, that went against him slightly. The fact that we were really banking on him once Rizwan was out. So I think I would say Shergil was possibly somebody that I was expecting a little bit more from today, but I'm sure he will come back.
Yeah, I think so too. I think his inclusion is very interesting as well, because there's been a lot of discussion around it. Of course, Fakhar Zaman not playing today because of a leg allergy. And I'm quoting the Pakistani selectors. Leg allergy. Just a one-word answer from you guys all, please. Have you guys ever heard of a leg allergy? Arman, have you heard of a leg allergy?
I have never heard of a leg allergy to a professional sportsman in the middle of a cricket tour, which sounds like the most basic thing to treat using an antihistamine, but apparently all of South Africa ran out of it. So, you know what? It is what it is. And we had to find a way to justify the selection of our guy, Shergil, and it didn't pay off. So, you know what? Double bad luck. Uski tang mein bhi allergy lag gayi. Hamare match mein bhi allergy lag gayi. Catch mein bhi allergy lag gayi. Welcome to Pakistani cricket.
I talked to her during the match as well, and I asked her. I was like, you know, what is that? What do they mean by allergy? She's like, I have no idea. She assumes it means like a pimple on the leg, and that's what they're referring to, and they called it an allergy. But even she was a bit confused, and she also said the whole thing about antihistamines as well in all of South Africa. Quite remarkable. It's a really bizarre thing, but either way, Fakhar was not included. Shergil came in. People have a lot of opinions whether he should be or shouldn't be playing. That's not what we're talking about. He's been in the squad. He's in the team. On performance alone, Ebba, I think you're totally justified in saying least favorite performance. Anam Nadeem, what was your least favorite performance of today's match?
I'd want Arman to shed some light on Babar's performance. I'll go with Shaheen Shah Afridi. Not because wo usne थोड़ी ज्यादा आज उसको फेंटी पड़ गई क्या, बट आई थिंक शाहीन नीड्स अ ब्रेक. वो इतना कंसिस्टेंटली इतने टाइम से खेलते आ रहा है, उसको कोई ब्रेक नहीं मिल रही. पीएसएल भी खेला, पाकिस्तान के लिए भी वो कंसिस्टेंटली खेलता आ रहा है. ये कोई बहुत डू एंड डाई सिचुएशन मैचेस नहीं है, तो आप उसको ब्रेक दे सकते हो यार. उस बेचारे को ब्रेक दे दो. इवन इफ ही सेज के मुझे ब्रेक नहीं चाहिए, आई थिंक मैनेजमेंट को वर्कलोड को मैनेज करना चाहिए. आगे टेस्ट मैच भी हमने खेलने हैं, उसमें भी शाहीन जो है वो इम्पोर्टेंट रोल प्ले करते हैं. तो आई थिंक ही नीड्स अ ब्रेक, एंड आई थिंक मैनेजमेंट को इस बारे में सोचना चाहिए.
They should think about Shaheen. But Shaheen's playing a lot of cricket. He's going to be in England as well, playing in the 100, where he won't be taking wickets. He'll be taking outs. We're going to talk about that another time. But he's not going to, they've changed the names of wickets to outs in the 100. Yeah, alag baat hai. Kisi aur waqt iske bare mein baat karenge. Arman, the floor is yours, buddy. I think you've got... I already know your least favorite performance of the match is Babar. Just tell me why.
क्या कर सकते हैं, मतलब कि आप कप्तान हैं, ब्लेसिंग है हमारे पाकिस्तान मुल्क के लिए, द प्राइड है, उसके खिलाफ कुछ बोल भी नहीं सकते, क्योंकि बोलेंगे भी तो यू नो इट डजंट साउंड गुड, बिकॉज वी लव हिम, बट यू नो द रियलिटी इज जस्ट देयर. यू कांट स्कोर 50 रन्स इन 50 बॉल्स. मैं एक चीज बस समझा देता हूँ वेरी वेरी क्विकली. स्ट्राइक रेट इज सो इम्पोर्टेंट. वाई इज इट सो इम्पोर्टेंट? हमारे हसन अली ने जो 400 की स्ट्राइक रेट की इन थ्री बॉल्स, ही स्कोर 2 sixes एंड ही गॉट आउट. Okay, he got out. You said he should go on. He only had like 3 overs or whatever it was. Anyways, but the point is, yeah, okay, when you strike rate high, you leave a lot of the other balls in the game that are available for other batsmen to try and score runs. When you have 50 balls, you only have 50 balls, get strike rate of 100. You should, you know, you're wasting so many balls that you could be scoring off. So, like, we're going for a World Cup here. I mean, I know that, you know, Babar is the most talented, the most beautiful, one of the best batsmen, if not, maybe arguably going to go on to be the best batsman Pakistan's ever produced. But do we care if we're not going to win World Cups? Do we care if we're not going to be number one? Do we care if we're constantly going to lose to England and we're going to constantly lose to India? Like, so at some point, the PCB and the captain have to realize you can't play for your stats and your averages and how great your technique is. And kya naam hai Babar Azam ka? Yaar, hum Pakistani fan hai, mein jeetna hai. So, like, you have to, there has to be an awareness of whether we're creating just people who are good, which thank God we are. Or are we creating a match-winning team? And I'll just leave it there because I don't want to go on and on. We've got wonderful guests here today. Let's listen to what she has to say. But that's it. These favorite performance, Babar. Slow strike rate.
I understand. I knew you would go that way. I understand it as well. You're not alone. a lot of people asking for more. What I will say in his defense, and you know, again, I won't go on about it. What I will say in his defense is, it's hard to point your finger at the guy who got 50 runs when all around him are players who struggled to get 10 runs or 12 runs or 15 runs. You know, I think, you know, okay, he wasn't at his paciest best or his best strike rate today. I wouldn't like to extrapolate this performance and say he's generally playing this way. I mean, that's just my brief defense of Barber, but I'll leave it to people in the comments. You know, I'm sure there's a lot of people who have strong opinions. I imagine mostly pro-Barber, maybe negative. Either way, leave it in your comments how you feel about Barber. But like Arman said, I'd acknowledge that he is a blessing to Pakistani cricket. Let's move on. There's so much to talk about. Ebba, it was a match full of moments, but amongst all these moments, what was your favorite moment of the match?
Okay, can I just go back to what Arman has just said about Babar, and I think that we're being really harsh on Babar because, like you said, rightly said, Adif, I think people, you know, around him, the wickets were falling like dominoes, right? So somebody's got to hold one end. Now, your mindset at that time would either be, I'm also going to go and start slogging because somebody needs to, you know, win this match or make runs for the team. Or shall I hold on to one end? Shall I be a responsible captain, hold on to one end and just keep the innings going from one end and let the other person settle on the other side? Now, that never happened. And I think, see, we are expecting something from Barber, an innings that he's not really played much of. Right. This is the way he plays. And we know he's played like that. There are some very few matches where he's actually slogged or he's gone crazy, you know, or where his strike rate has been like what we are expecting. So I think we need to really have a reality check here. Why do we suddenly want Babar Azam to turn into a superhero who completely comes out of his comfort zone and starts playing like somebody we want him to play like? Because that's not his natural game. So what he is doing right now, what he did today, is what he does majority of the time. And that is to save one side of the innings, to build the innings, and to score in the end as well. And Arman, also in answer to your question, you're not the only one asking this. There's a lot of people on Twitter who I see ask the same question. Is they're playing for themselves, they're playing for the strike rate, they're playing for their numbers, you know, for their own score. I don't know, and I'm saying this from my personal experience, I don't know any player that goes in to say, right, today I'm going to score a personal 50. I'm just going to score for myself. It's not, you know, it seems that way when we're sitting outside, and I'm having to break the glass around you here, but that's the way they go in. And if he's a captain, he definitely wants to score for the team. He definitely wants Pakistan to win because that's a win-win situation for him. But that's in his defense. But I totally get what you're saying. I do agree. If I was an outsider, didn't know anything, you know, what's going on in, I'd say the same thing that, oh, why did he play so slow? Why did he make 50 on 50? Who plays like that in T20? I'd probably say that to Azhar if he'd come back doing a 50 out of 50 when he played in those. So that definitely give him an earful. But I know that he doesn't go with the intention of, I just want to score my runs. I just want my strike rate to be this. I just want to be on this ranking or, you know, whatever. I definitely think Pakistan didn't turn up today. They definitely didn't. Not what we were seeing. I was really impressed throughout the South African series that they've actually impressed me. They've actually, you know, I've been surprised because I really thought we're going to be in trouble. But to be fair to South Africa, they played really well today. And they have been playing. And this is not their first team. This is actually, they've got quite a young team, haven't they? So if we look at that, they've done quite well. And my moment, Adif, in answer to your question, I think today would be when Hassan came out and hit that huge six. I think, if I'm not wrong, my daughter tells me this, it was 89 metres because I've not checked out how far it'd gone. But, I think Hassan is amazing. Hassan brings life to an innings. Whether he's coming on to bowl or whether he's coming on to bat, I really look forward to a player like that. And I just think he did that today again. And he really got our hopes up. Even though he scored, was it 12 or something out of three from three balls? I just think he needs to stop being so aggressive, though, because he goes into this aggressive mode and then he's out. He needs to kind of control his aggression and build his innings as well. But I think that was the moment for me when he came in and hit that huge six.
It was a spectacular moment. And he's such a dynamic player as well, Hassan Ali. You know, he can really influence the game. I mean, I will never forget his performance in the last match of the final of the Qaid-e Azam Trophy, where he showed exactly how much of an all-rounder talent he is with that extraordinary innings as captain of Central Punjab. Like, he absolutely right. But I think if he just applies himself a little bit more, he could be a genuine all-rounder for Pakistan. get some valuable runs for them. I'd agree with that. And again, I'd invite everybody watching to share some thoughts about Babur. Like I'm in the Babur camp as well. I think like you, Eb, I recognize that he had a responsibility at the time to play the way he did. But I also recognize that there's frustration about the low score that Pakistan has scored. And Armand brought up a reasonable point. Anyway, let's move on from Babur from now. Let's leave that for the comments. Anam, tell me, what was your moment of the match?
अच्छा अभी चेंज किया मैंने मैंने कुछ और सोचा हुआ था और अभी बस एकदम से मुझे लगा कि नहीं आई थिंक मोमेंट ऑफ द मैच है रिजवान का पहली बॉल पे आउट होना. रिजवान हैज बीन अ कंसिस्टेंट रन गेटर फॉर अस और आज जिस तरह से वो पहली बॉल पे आउट हुआ है वो शायद वहां से जो है ना मैच का मोमेंटम एकदम से साउथ अफ्रीका के हक में चला गया और हम लोग शायद रिजवान के आउट होते हमें भूल गया कि हमने बाकी बैट्समैन ने भी कुछ स्कोर करना है बाकी लोगों ने भी कुछ करना है. रिजवान बेचारे पे सारी जिम्मेदारी डाली हुई थी और वो आउट हो गया एंड दिस इज हाउ इट इज.
Yeah, I agree with you, Anam. It was a big moment. It was very jarring, actually. You get DSM, they extended this one. He's so consistent. PSL for Pakistan in T20s. He was looked in good touch in the previous T20 as well. To see him get out first, well, it doesn't happen. It's like, I mean, don't hate me in the comments. It just feels, it was like when you saw Tendulkar get out for zero. It didn't happen very often, is what I mean to say, right? I'm not making a direct comparison. Leave me alone in the comments, okay? Armand, what was your moment of the match, bro?
यार मैं क्या करूं अनिम जी की यही तो यू नो खास बात है कि वो 15 उनके पास मोमेंट्स होते हैं हमेशा मेरा वाला ले लेती हैं लेकिन आई एम डेफिनेटली गोइंग टू से द सेम थिंग बिकॉज़ यू नो दैट इज व्हाट माय मोमेंट वाज एंड यू नो इट लिंक्स बैक टू द थिंग दैट वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट बाबर एंड आइदर साइड आई जस्ट लाइक द इंटेंट शोन देयर एंड आई वुड से दैट दिस इज नॉट समथिंग दैट यू कैन टेक इन आइसोलेशन. There is a problem with the Pakistani batting lineup. Theek hai na? Or the problem is that we are playing our openers at three. We did it in the last game as well. Fakhar Zaman was playing at three and Shajila there. There is now pressure in this camp. And make no doubts about it. There is pressure in this camp because the top order have been consistent, but they're not scoring at a very high strike rate. So Rizwan's got a phenomenal record. Babur's got a phenomenal record. But the pressure right now is if Pakistan are going to go on and compete against India and against England, we need high strike rates. And that's why Fakhar has been drafted into the squad after his blistering innings in the ODIs. That's why Shajil Khan is in this squad because of the fact. And, Shajil didn't have a lot of support behind him. He's been coming into this squad on the basis of the fact that as an opener, if he gets going, he has a devastating strike rate. So now we're seeing the impact of competition within their squad, in my opinion. That is why you're seeing an uncharacteristic shot. I don't expect Rizwan to usually go for a shot like that or get out on the first ball for a duck in those kind of circumstances. So for me, that was the moment of the match. And unlike maybe a lot of the others that were like, oh my God, Rizwan out and Pakistan, if Rizwan doesn't score, Pakistan aren't winning. That's kind of the formula at the moment with Pakistan and T20. I think the opposite. I think that if we can start to make these changes at the top of our innings and have a more positive mindset and not worry about the fact that, oh my God, someone didn't score. Please don't drop him. Please don't, put him down to number six because he didn't get a score today. Be patient, have the right approach and work hard at it, keep practicing. And then I don't want to hear, India ke naye bacche kitne high strike rate pe khelte hain, Pakistan mein koi hai nahi. That's what I keep hearing all the time. We've got the players. The reason they don't is because they are not backed when they don't succeed. And when you play a high-risk strategy, you have to allow them to fail. That's my opinion. Good luck to Rizwan in the next game because he's also a blessing to Pakistan.
Yeah, I can agree with some of that. I think consistency is definitely important. I still feel bad for Bichara Danish. He got those two games against South Africa on those bouncy tracks and it seems like it's game over for him. He's been sent back to 50-over cricket. If you're going to play somebody, if you're going to back them in the squad and find a space for them, you got to give them a proper run. I do believe that. But also, I think you got to play your best 11. We could go around in circles, really. I'll give you my moment. My moment is more centered around a sequence of moments. It's about Tabriz Shamsi, basically. Because here's a guy who was getting taken to task by Fakhar Zaman in that one-day international series. He's come back so strongly. I mean, people were talking about Maharaj, the hype around Maharaj, and he's the better spinner or whatever. Tabriz Shamsi surprises a lot of people, was number one in the T20 bowling rankings, and he showed why. Like, he bowled with great control. He's got a very flashy celebration that I know a lot of people took the wrong way, but Anam pointed out in the previous show, which I recommend if you've not seen, go check out the previous show, that he's been doing it for a long time. So Tabriz Shamsi putting in a business-like performance for me was my moment of the match. Guys, it's 1-1. Pakistan have lost the second match. A lot of people fancied them to go 4-0. Armand said 4-0. I think Anam said 4-0 as well. I think Arif said 4-0 as well. I think I was the only one who went with a 3-1. So I need them to win the next two games to be right. Let's go with Ebba first. Ebba, what do you see happening differently in the next game? And who do you think is going to win?
What I think is going to be totally to what's actually going to happen, I'm sure. But I think, and I would like to hope, that they keep the same team. They don't do any, you know, they don't press any panic buttons and they start dropping people and bringing Fakhar back and stuff. Look, if Fakhar is taking a rest or whether he's got an allergic reaction to something on his leg, which is probably the correct version of the story. But, I just think that Shergil should still stay where he is and give him another go. I think that they are going to change their mindset. They're obviously going to look at what they've done wrong today and they're going to come back and change that. You know, Ababa is going to be possibly looking back at what he's done today as well. You know, I'm sure he's aware of it as well. So he'll probably come in with a different mindset. They know that South Africa team is going to remain the same. This is who they're playing. They've played some youngsters today. So, you know, against some youngsters today as well. So I don't see much change. I hope not to see any changes. But this is Pakistan. You never know. They might want to strengthen their middle order and they might kind of, you know, change the list, the order of the batting lineup a little bit, maybe. But I just feel that we shouldn't press the panic button. I don't think it was the end of the world today. I see that we should definitely, you know, I see us winning the series. I'm not, obviously, it's not going to be 4-0, but, you know, we will definitely, we're more than capable of levelling this up. I just hope to God they don't press any panic buttons and change, just drop anyone, unless somebody's injured or having a niggle.
There we go. Hopefully nobody's got any more funky allergies or nak allergy or tongue allergy. Hopefully none of that is going to happen. And we can see an unchanged team. I'd agree with that, Ebba. I don't mind the Harris and Hasnain rotation. I don't feel, you know, I don't, that's the only issue I have. It's not even an issue. I don't mind how they play them as long as they're both getting a bit of action. Anand Nadeem, what do you think? Who's winning the next game? And what changes do you expect to see?
Pakistan should win the next game. मतलब ठीक है आज जिस तरह से हारे it should be एक reality check भी था कि भाई चीजें जो हैं बाबर ने post match में बोला कि जी हमारी team complacent नहीं थी बस अच्छा नहीं खेल सकी we didn't turn up for the day तो probably अगले match में उनको पता है कि भाई बहुत उम्मीदें हैं सारे लोगों की और उनको खुद भी पता है they need to perform well so I hope they are able to do that I want Shaheen to rest. I want to see Arshad Iqbal being brought into the mix of things. Usko leke gaye hain to usko bhi ek match de. Aur Shaheen ko rest de. I'm not saying ki Shaheen kuch bura kar raha hai nahi kar raha. I'm just saying ki he needs rest. Usko ek achhi headspace mein jaane ki zarurat hai. Aur iske ilawa nahi I think bas haan. Baaki team bhi rahe mujhe koi masla nahi.
Atif, can I just say something about Shaheen? Sorry, Anam, I'm cutting you here.
No.
Only because I might be able to give my 2 pence worth here. I just want to drop a question in. What if Shaheen doesn't want to rest?
Yeah, see, this has been brought up by a few people as well, Ebba. It's interesting you say that because a lot of people share Anam's perspective that, you know, this guy's being overworked. His workload is crazy, especially against, people keep calling a second string South African team. Like, does he really need to be there for Pakistan to win? But also, you know, this guy is a young guy. He's just turned 21 years old. He's playing a lot of cricket. Even sort of people talk about resting players. You know, when we go back to sort of the days when there would be long tours where a team would arrive, if Pakistan arrived in England, they would play 3 matches against the counties, 1 against a university before they'd ever even see an English test team. They'd still be working hard and grinding. He seems fit. He seems healthy. And if we were to give him a break, I imagine the PCB are thinking, is there a temptation for this guy to go and off and play like league cricket somewhere? He's already playing in the 100. Is he going to play in the T20 Blast? Is he going to go and play in this Abu Dhabi one or the Canada one? There's T20s all over the place. So, yeah. But I understand both perspectives, really. I'm curious to get everybody else's perspective. If you're watching, please mention in the comments, would you like to see Shaheen rest? Or do you think if the boy wants to play, let him play? Arman Kirmani, next match, who's winning? And what changes do you expect to see?
Yeah, I obviously predict 4-0 because I'm a diehard Pakistani fan. I can never pick anybody else. Lekin, obviously, it's not going to be 4-0 now, so I'm going to have to say 3-1. So, obviously, I will go for Pakistan to win the next game. Lekin, jo khatra hai na, it's not the fact that South Africa will outplay us. They did outplay us today, by the way. Lekin, how much of this was them outplaying us? and how much was it us not having the right tactics and the right strategy in place. So mujhe wo cheez ka bada khatra lag raha hai kyunki jab hamari strategy sahi nahi hogi hum openers ko teen pe khilayenge slower strike rate ko open karayenge bowlers ko rest nahi denge. This, it feels like we're not managing the situation against a second string South African team. Then we're going to go to Zimbabwe. Then we're going to come back to PSL. Then we're going to go to West Indies. Then we're going to play England. Then maybe India will come. Matlab ki aap rest nahi karoge, so you're going to create a superhuman Shaheen Afridi by the time he's there. That's great if he is superhuman. But if he's human and he breaks down, who's taking responsibility that we're going to the World Cup without a premier fast bowler fully fit? Tell me that answer. Because why would anyone not want to play for Pakistan? That makes total sense. He never wants to rest. But if he breaks down and plays more games than any other fastball in the history of cricket has played before the World Cup and gets injured, tell me, who do I go to and hold accountable for that blunder? Tell me that.
There you go. Well, I mean, that's a pretty strong perspective as well. Listen, you're all making good points. I find it hard to agree or disagree with any of you. I personally don't have a strong opinion on the Shaheen situation, but I'm, again, curious to hear what everybody else thinks. Arman making the very good point of, like, burnout ahead of a World T20. Anam making the same point about, you know, just needing to rest this guy as we're playing nonstop. But equally, Ebba, you're bang on. If the guy wants to play, it's hard to stop him playing. Maybe that's where management kicks in. But yeah, for my two cents, I would play the exact same team as I said before as well. I'd play the exact same team. I'd back Pakistan to learn from this defeat, to get that wake-up call, as Anam said, and come back stronger. They are the stronger team on paper as well and on performance. What happened in the second match feels like an anomaly. I say that with the greatest respect for the South African team. I do think, you know, there's some talented players in their ranks, but they're just not at full strength right now. So with that being said, it's been lovely to speak to you all. Thank you so much for making the time. Anam, Arman, superb as always. A big thank you to our special guest, Ebba Qureshi. You must find her on social media. Follow her great social causes that she supports. The walkathon in Pakistan recently was a superb effort. So well done on that. And she's just generally got great content as well. So I highly recommend following her on social media. Ebba, let me let you go. Do you have any final remarks?
I just want to say it's been a pleasure being on here. I was extremely nervous because I said to Arthur, if I warned him, I said, don't ask me any technical questions. My husband will kill me when I come off this podcast. But yeah, my daughters were prepping me and everything. So I enjoyed myself. And thank you so much for letting me have an opinion apart from sitting behind a keyboard and just putting my opinion on Twitter. But yeah, you know, it was great. And guys, it's been lovely to hear your opinions as well. And all the best for the show. And good luck, Pakistan, at the end.
Absolutely. Couldn't have said it better. Thank you so much, Ebba. It's been a pleasure. Our best to the family, obviously. Arman, Anam, thank you so much. Everybody watching, we'll be back after the third T20 in this series. Of course, our coverage of the IPL is ongoing as well, so make sure you watch those videos if you're watching the IPL. If not, no problem at all. But do remember to subscribe. That really helps us out. Subscribe, like, retweet, follow, all the things you have to do. Apologies for my video quality. I'm having to do this in my car, which also reminds me to wish those of you that are celebrating tomorrow a very happy Ramzan Mubarak to everybody who's going to be fasting from tomorrow or the day after around the world. We here at Post Match Chat are done. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next time. Bye.